a Piazza Grande. Buonasera Giona.
Buonasera Giada, buonasera Piazza Grande.
Ben ritrovati per una serata molto ricca con due film diversi tra loro decisamente, ma questa è anche la Piazza Grande che permette di unire universi molto diversi tra loro, ma iniziamo con una celebrazione importante. Celebriamo questa sera il 70° anniversario della Convenzione sui rifugiati. La Convenzione, firmata da 144 stati contraenti, definisce il termine rifugiato e specifica tanto i diritti dei migranti forzati, tanto gli obblighi legali degli stati a proteggerli. Ne parliamo con un ospite, possiamo davvero dire, d'eccezione. Si tratta di Gillian Triggs, assistente alto commissario per la protezione dell'Alto Commissariato ONU per i rifugiati e assistente segretario generale delle Nazioni Unite. Buonasera e benvenuta a Gillian Triggs. Welcome to the Locarno Film Festival. Gillian Triggs, benvenuta qui in Piazza Grande. Welcome to the Piazza.
Thank you very much. It's wonderful to be with you.
Why is the Refugee Convention so important? I mean, after 7 years, what is its significance today?
Well, firstly, thank you so much on behalf of the UN Refugee Agency for this opportunity to join with you and the Locarno Film Festival to celebrate 70 years of the Refugee Convention. And this is the place to do it because, of course, the Refugee Convention was agreed here in Switzerland 70 years ago. And I've actually brought a copy of it with me. This is the convention. And, and Switzerland has every reason to be very proud because, and that to answer your question, the convention and the principles of the convention has saved many, many millions of lives over these 70 years, and Switzerland has been right behind it. So good on you, Switzerland. Thank you.
And after 70 years, what are still the biggest challenges that refugees all over are facing, and how can we help them?
Well, unfortunately, we still are in a period of unprecedented global conflicts. We have conflicts over many, many years, the fifth decade now of the conflict in Afghanistan, Syria 11 years, but we also have newer conflicts in Ethiopia and in Mozambique. So I'm afraid the real reason something like 82 million people are displaced, 26 million of them refugees, is because of conflict in the world. So there are other root causes, of course, of poverty and inequality, but the real problem is the lack of an ability to find peace. And that's been, that I think is quite tragic, to produce so many people in need of protection. But what can we do about it? Well, that's really why we're so privileged to be part of the Locarno Film Festival. Because you can tell the stories in ways that perhaps someone like me can't. I'm a lawyer, I can tell you the numbers, I can tell you about the law and this wonderful convention, but it doesn't move hearts as well as minds. Whereas all of you making films, coming to see films, can understand the story of a grandmother caring for her grandchildren when the mother has been killed in a conflict. When young children have no access to school in refugee camps. These are the individual stories, and every individual story is worth telling. So that's why we're so very, very honored to be part of the Locarno Film Festival, because this festival is a festival based on values and on the humanitarian principles. So thank you all very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. We are honored. Thank you very much. Gillian Triggs, thank you so much. E io ricordo ancora che Gillian Triggs vi incontrerà domani alle 10.30 al Forum La Rotonda, vi incontrerà per una discussione pubblica alla quale potrete naturalmente partecipare tutti e porre anche delle domande. E ora, John, presentiamo il primo film di questa sera, un'opera prima di un regista giordano che crediamo farà molto parlare di sé.
Sì, il film di questa sera si intitola The Alice, ed è un film che ci piaceva portare in Piazza Grande, è un'opera prima, Ed è un film che per certi versi ricorda il grande cinema neorealista italiano. Ci sono dei tocchi di commedia, ci sono delle punte di dramma sociale, ci sono persino degli sapori noir, e il tutto sullo sfondo di della capitale della Giordania esplorata nei suoi aspetti meno noti. E quindi ci è sembrato anche un film che in qualche modo potesse cambiare il modo in cui il pubblico percepisce le storie che vengono dal Medio Oriente, ma anche da altre parti del mondo, che non necessariamente devono sempre essere legate alla cronaca degli aspetti che purtroppo nel tutti i giorni seguiamo nei notiziari. E quindi abbiamo pensato che questo film potesse magari aiutare il pubblico a cambiare la percezione di certe realtà.
And our first film tonight is centered on issues of personal reputation, religious freedom and female empowerment. Let's discover it with the film's delegation. I have the pleasure of calling on stage the director, Bassel Gandur. Welcome to Locarno. Good evening. And I'll continue with the producer, Youssef Abed Annabi. Good evening. And with the actors, Emad Azmi, Muter Rayane, Baraka Ramani, and Maiza Abd Eladi. Welcome to Locarno.
Bassel, you have previously worked in films and then you moved on to directing your own film. I had the privilege of following some of the stages you went through, but what were the real challenges in moving from script writing to directing and putting a project on its feet?
First, thank you so much for having us, Jonah, and thank you to the whole Locarno team for inviting us. The move from writing and producing to writing and directing, I have to say, with Veeb, our first film, as producers, we were very creatively involved. So it gave us that hunger to want, it gave me personally that hunger to want to direct. In fact, the whole crew was very collaborative. Everybody was involved in every aspect of the filmmaking, so it was everybody helping, and we took that same energy and that same joy and love of filmmaking and brought it into the alleys, and you know, I had an amazing team to help me out. So
yeah, I would like also to ask the actors, how was the atmosphere on the set? What was it like to work with Bassel?
As Bassel mentioned, he's a very collaborative director. He asked us a lot every step of the way what we thought about the characters. Sometimes he would check in with us about the camera angles, stuff like that. I actually also asked to shadow Bassel when I wasn't on in front of the camera, and he was gracious, and it was just a really great experience.
Yeah, working with Bassel is just a blessing, really. Like, I was blessed to be able to be working with Bassel. He's a very collaborative director, and he was leading us like on every single step of the way. So I feel honored and thankful that I had the chance to work with you. Thank you.
And
please.
Thank you, Bassel.
Well, I have to ask you this. Did you ever imagine that you would world premiere your film here in this square with this wonderful audience tonight?
Never in my wildest dream, never in our wildest dreams, really. I mean, there's no better place to exhibit, and man, it's full. I'm quite nervous. I hope you all enjoy it, really, genuinely. This is magical.
Thank you. We leave you the stage for a picture, and we will stay here,
yes,
right?
Let's do
okay.
It.
Wanted to take a picture here.
Yeah. I mean, who doesn't?
We'll wait for you.
You have to turn.
Oh.
Thank you so much. Enjoy
it's
your evening.
It's better than a selfie.
Enjoy the film. E ora, Giona, presentiamo il secondo film di questa serata che invitiamo davvero tutti a vedere, a restare questa sera. È un film di un regista caro al festival, con un protagonista d'eccezione. So che ti ha toccato il cuore.
Sì, è un film assolutamente sorprendente di un cineasta che non ha mai smesso di sorprendere e questo probabilmente è il suo, diciamolo, capolavoro. Ed è un film che nasce da delle esigenze molto personali e ci ha rivelato nel suo aspetto più vulnerabile, un regista che invece eravamo abituati a considerare come qualcuno che ci spaventava a morte. Ed è stata anche questa intuizione, questo colpo di genio da parte di, diciamo il nome, certo, Gaspar Noé, di chiamare Dario Argento a interpretare un film così intimo, così prezioso. E abbiamo pensato che, nonostante apparentemente tocchi dei temi così sensibili, in fondo è un film che ci dà una voglia enorme di vivere.
Gaspar Noé has always surprised us, film after film, but nothing could have prepared us for the emotion of this one. Nous avons maintenant le grand plaisir d'accueillir sur scène le réalisateur Gaspar Noé. Bonsoir, bienvenue.
Bonsoir.
Bienvenue.
Merci pour les compliments.
Ce n'était pas des compliments, c'est la vérité.
Un chef-d'œuvre, c'est un compliment. qu'est-ce que je veux dire? Malheureusement, les trois stars du film, Dario Argento, Françoise Lebrun et Alex Lutz, ne pouvaient pas venir et ils mouraient tous les trois d'envie de venir. Je crois que eux trois, comme moi, on a vu que vous pleuriez beaucoup, beaucoup, beaucoup. Il paraît que quand on pleure, il y a des molécules qui sont dans l'hypophyse qui passent dans des états de stress ultime. Ça passe derrière les yeux, ça se met en contact avec les membranes qui sont sous les yeux et ça fait l'effet d'un Xanax beaucoup plus fort. Donc, quand il arrive des trucs très douloureux dans la vie, on pleure beaucoup et ça fait du bien. Ça fait beaucoup, beaucoup de bien.
Vous avez parlé des trois protagonistes incroyables.
Ah non, il ne faut pas traduire en anglais ?
Non.
Bon, je ne parle pas trop vite. Les trois protagonistes sont incroyables, vous allez le voir, je n'ai pas besoin de faire l'apologie, c'est explicite sur l'écran. Ils ont improvisé tous les dialogues parce que mon scénario, il ne faisait que 10 pages. 10 pages que j'ai écrites à la fin du mois de janvier. On a préparé le film au mois de février, on l'a tourné en avril-mai. On l'a fini d'urgence pour Cannes. Et du coup, aujourd'hui, c'est la deuxième présentation publique. Et je suis très content de le voir à l'air libre, parce que ça n'arrive nulle part ailleurs au monde. Et voilà, je suis le plus heureux des hommes de présenter le film ici.
Comment vous avez pensé à Dario Argento pour le rôle?
Est-ce que tu connais quelqu'un de plus charismatique que lui?
Moi, je cet âge-là,
moi, j'en connais pas. C'était ma première idée. Sa fille, Asia Argento, m'a aidé à le convaincre. Heureusement, le film qu'il est en train de tourner en ce moment a été décalé et du coup, il avait un mois de libre avant de commencer son film. Et j'ai réussi à le convaincre avec l'aide d'Asia. Et voilà, c'est la meilleure chance que de pouvoir l'avoir lui et avoir Françoise Lebrun dans le film aussi. Voilà, des fois, les étoiles sont bien alignées. Et les étoiles sont bien alignées. On a fait ça en toute vitesse pour que le plus grand nombre de gens puissent pleurer à gorge déployée. Profitez-en, préparez vos Kleenex et bonne chance.
Gaspar Noé.
Merci beaucoup, Gaspar Noé. Merci. Bonsoirée à vous toutes et tous. Enjoy the films, the two films, and see you tomorrow.
Buona visione, Locarno. Buona serata.